out of my head, right? Because I'm not feeding you what the palace wants me to feed you. Daniel said, you take the food home, you feed your family, do whatever you want, give us grains, that's all. I says, you'll see in 10 days that we'll look better than you. And he did. 10 days later, he saw he had a great deal, this his servant, right? He'd take all the food home, whatever. Daniel had only veggie, right? But they were better. Esther also was the same thing. Yeah. Questions, anyone?
Can we talk about the power of the Yahrzeit of this policy?
Can we talk about the power of the Yahrzeit of Rebbe Meir about this? First of all, understand the power of any Yahrzeit, your parents or whatever it may be. The Yahrzeit, it's brought in Svarim that the day of the Yahrzeit, why do we celebrate it, why do we say Kaddish, you know that? Because on that day, the soul is judged again, right? The person is judged when they pass away, judgment is passed when the year passes. On the day of passing, the soul is brought to judgment again. And hopefully that person went up to a level, something good happened during that past year for the sake of the soul. For instance, the grandchildren or the children did mitzvahs, stuff like that. So the soul is now judged worthy of going up to a higher level. So that every Yahrzeit that passes, it's an opportunity for a person to beg in the name of the person who passed away. Right, they're going to a much higher level. They have a greater power to draw down even more yeshuot, more salvation from Hashem. Okay? Yeah. Let's take, the question is, Rav Meir Bavanes. I mean, it's always been a fascinating topic, Rav Meir. The Gemara starts off in Erevin, talks about Rav Meir. And it says, Rabbi Yishmael had a Talmud, Rabbi Meir, who was so bright that his friends could not delve down to the depths of Rabbi Meir's reasoning. That's why the halacha is not always like him, because he was too deep for his friends. This is Rabbi Meir. Who were Rabbi Meir's friends? Right? Rabbi Yehuda. Shimon by Yechoy, Rabbi Yossi ben Chalafta, Elozo ben Shemua, and I mean, you have a lineup, right? That any all star, right? Will take these guys on the. I mean, these are the stars of the Mishnah. These are the stars of the Mishnah, and yet Rabbi Meir's depth was so great. Yerushalmi tells us. Sanhedrin, when Rabbi Akiva was about to be put to death. So Rabbi Akiva was the Rosh Hashiva. So the choice then for the Rosh Hashiva was either Rabbi Meir or Rabbi Shimon Bar Yochai. Right? He asked Rabbi Akiva who should be the Rosh Hashiva. He said Rabbi Meir. Right? So it says Rabbi Shimon's face turned red. You know, not me, whatever. Rabbi Akiva told, this is, by the way, more in favor of Rabbi Shimon. The Gemara over there says that Rabbi Akiva turned to Rabbi Shimon and told him, it's enough for you to know that Hashem and me know how great you are. But Rabbi Meir was able to give out the different teachings and the Mishnah, Gemara in Sanhedrin says, Stam Masnisman. Stam Matnitin, every Mishnah in Stam, it's Rav Meir who said it. Rav Meir taught the Mishnah. Unless you find other people who have mentioned it, it's Rav Meir who taught the Mishnah. It was Rav Meir who gave it over, and that's how it came down to us. So Rav Meir is really the primary transmitter of the Torah that we have from Rav Akiva. And Rav Shimon ben Yochai was the primary teacher of the Kabbalah, that the Meir is mentioned in the Zohar, but only a couple of times. And he was, it was Rav Shimon who brought the Zohar to us. That's the Kabbalah. The Nigla was brought to us basically through Rav Meir. You had Rav Yehuda, you had this interesting Gemara in Kedusha. Gemara says that when Rav Meir passed away, and we'll get to it in a minute, when Rav Meir passed away, Rav Yehuda said, don't let Rav Meir's students into the Beis Medrash. He says, why? Because they were argumentative. They asked too many questions, right? And so on. I mean, is Rav Meir had a certain way of learning that brought it down to that. Rav Meir was, you couldn't understand his depth. Okay. What do we know of the greatness of Rav Meir? Rav Meir was the son-in-law of Rav Chanina ben Tradjan. Rav Chanina ben Tradjan was the one of the 10 martyrs, the one who was wrapped in the Sefer Torah and burned alive. He, his wife, daughter, whatever, his wife was punished with one thing. His daughter was sent to a brothel. At the time of his daughter was sent to a brothel. Rav Meir's wife was a sister of this daughter. She said, how can you leave my sister there? You got to get her out. Now, we're talking about the Roman Empire. Weren't too friendly to anybody, let alone to a Jew.
Gemara
Avodah Zarah,
right?
Huh? Avodah Zarah. I think it's Tess, Tess or something like that. So the Gemara there says, very good. So the Gemara says there that she prevailed, Beruya, Meir's wife, prevailed on Meir to go save her. Yeah. Rav Meir goes over to the prison. He says, what do you want? He says, I want that girl. She says, you can't have her. She's here, you know. He says, I want her. Here's money. Gave him a lot of money. He says, I can't take it. They'll come here, they'll ask for that girl. She's not here, they'll kill me. So Rav Meir said to him, and this is where the famous statement comes from. He says, say, Elokod de Meir Aneni. God of Meir should answer you. Just say that. And the guy left. He says, man, if I say it, so what? Bring me proof. There were two huge dogs, like Rottweilers or maybe Dobermans, who knows what. But they were there, huh? Pit bulls, whatever. Okay, they had all this kind of shalom aleichem. Stand at 6:30, huh? I love you too. Okay. Anyway, so he said, let the dogs loose. They let the dogs loose, they were running after the guy, and the mayor said, say it. And they called the mayor, and they need the dogs quieted down. They became little pets, right? And that's where the famous statement is, with Mayor Balanes, right? The mayor says, and they called the mayor, and they need to say, Hashem, the God of the mayor, should answer me. And that's what brought the mayor, this food in the back.
It's okay.
It's okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
He's a great host.
So, Elokod de Meir Aneni. That's where the miracle came from. Right? But now, word got out that, you know, Meir is doing these kind of acts and whatnot, so he had to run away. The Roman guards found him. They started chasing after him. So he ran into a, like a big ball. There was like a party going on. By one of the Roman emperors, one of the Roman authorities. So he ran into the hall, and he's looking around, they're after him. So he stuck his finger into the tray for food, right? And he started sucking on his finger. And they said, Rav Meir would never do anything like that. Even if his life was in danger, he would never touch tray food. Therefore, you know, it's not Rav Meir, leave him alone, it's somebody else. Right? Murray asked though, what did Rav Meir do? I mean, did he stick? He says he stuck one finger in and he sucked on the other finger. That's what he did. Rav Meir would never eat the tray food. Then he had to flee. He fled to Chutz Laaretz. Rav Meir fled to Chutz Laaretz. He was there for a little while. Came time for his passing. He told the people where he was. This is Yerushalmi in Kalayim. Yerushalmi says, he told the people that when I die, just put me on a flock of wood,